guys! Okay, so I am in my living room. As you can see, I'm not in my bedroom because I am doing a video on scuba diving. I'm going to show you all my equipment and then I'm going to put it all on. So underneath this, I have my bathing suit on, but I didn't feel like doing this in a bikini top, so I put on my coat, but as you can see, nothing. Just kidding. No, seriously. But anyways, so yeah, just give y'all a heads up of what's gonna come. If you don't want to watch this, exit out now. If you do, have fun. So we're gonna get started with one of the most important things. That is wetsuits. I have two. They're both 5mm. They're both Henderson. I have a long one. Basically covers this part. It has no sleeves. Just covers down to your feet. And then I have what's called a shorty, which is another 5 that I wear over it, which has shorts with sleeves. So basically what that does is gives me more warmth here where I need it. So those are those. Ugh, very important. Dive log. I have this. This is my dive log. For every single diver out there, you must keep a dive log. And what this is basically, you open it, it's got your name. You basically put every single dive that you've ever done in here. And you put your notes on it, where it was, what number dive, how long it took. It's very complicated, but you must do it. Because some places where you go to dive, you have to show them this. And you have to have a certain number of dives to reach certain certifications. So that's that. My dad bought me these from Hollis, which are very good gloves. When you strap it on like that, and see, your hand's basically not stuck. You can move it, but it's kind of in that position. But they remind me of like gloves that like knights wear. Eventually, one of two things happens. Your wetsuit and your gloves and your booties and whatever will fill with water and will start heating you up. Or two, you will go numb and you just won't feel anything. And these are my booties. And these are Manta, I'm gonna say. Yeah, Aries Manta. They're booties. And they just zip up. And what these do is you have to wear these. These are what you wear on your feet. And your fins go over them. Because you wear your fins on your bare feet. They will rub against your feet and callus and hurt. It's very painful. I got this. I actually tried to wear this when I was in Florida. And I wore it for one dive down in Blue Grotto, which is about 102 feet. Down. It was pretty funny, but then I took it off because it was just getting annoying. But I thought it was pretty cool. I don't really know what it's for, but you just tie it in the back. This right here is a light I won actually at a raffle, and you tie it onto your tank. And basically what happens when it gets wet, it flashes. So if you're somewhere dark, like in a cave, or if you're night diving, people know where you are. It flashes red. Basically, everything that could be in pink is in pink. This was my first snorkel I ever got. But this snorkel I especially ordered. This is the one that I use. And it's from Mayer's, which is a very, very good brand. Very expensive, very high quality brand. And what this is you see the top of this. If you go underwater with this, and this hits underwater, water is going to go into here and into your mouth. With this one, there's a little flap. I don't know if you can hear that. And so what happens is once it hits underwater, it stops. So it keeps water from coming in here. So you don't have to worry about inhaling water, which is why they're expensive. I don't really do that much snorkeling. Here's my flashlight, which, whoa, that was a really cool effect. That was cool. Yeah. That just entertained me. Tablet? My writing tablet? I don't know. You can see I've written on it. It's very hard to get off. Basically what it does is it ties under your wrist. And this is a piece of charcoal type stuff. You take it out and you can write underwater. And what I use it for is when you come up for your decompression and you have to, once you get a certain depth, you have to go back up and you have to wait a certain amount of minutes for the nitrogen in your blood to leave before you can go back down, or else you'll get the bends. And so basically, and you have to log that in your dive log. And so instead of getting out of the water or trying to remember, I just write it on here. Aha! Let's see if I can get this open. I'm gonna have to use my teeth. Aha! It's one of those days. I shouldn't have left it out. This is my mask. It's Mare's again, but it's pink, of course. I went out and bought for like $5 another strap, again pink, which reversible is green if you wanted green, but I chose pink so when I'm diving, someone is behind me that can tell who I am. Okay, here's our life-saving device. This is the regulator. This is what hooks onto your tank. This is very heavy. This is, I think, Sherwood? Yes. Yes, Sherwood. This is the regulator. This hooks on to the BC, which I will show in a second. You just flick it on, hook it up. This is my compass, computer, and this shows how much air I have left. And this is the part that goes in your mouth, Sherwood Magnum. So as you can see, it goes in your mouth like that. You can press this and it purges. So that hasn't been used in a while. Okay. These are my fins. These are the first fins I ever got, and I do plan on getting new ones because these are kind of at their end, even though they're less than 2 years old. These are ProMate fins. These fins were about $100, and again, they're pink, but they're very big, and they've got these little things inside of them that you put inside to keep them from going flat. Put that back. This is all in a big, huge dive bag. Is there anything else in here? Oh, this is my first compass I got before I got my computer. I had to tie it on my wrist, even though I didn't use it. Okay. Now for this stuff. This I got as a Christmas present from my dad the year I started diving. And it is, let's see if I can get this together right. And it goes that way. If you've ever seen any of my videos on YouTube of me diving, the videos that I've taken, this is what I've used. This is my Icolite camera. Well, this is just the casing for it. The camera itself is upstairs because I used it to take to New York. But basically what it is, you know, you just hold it and it's got, you can turn the flash. You can take this thing off, on and off. You just turn it on and off, and if you don't want to use the strobe, you can just, well, there, you can just use this little part, and I have this because this clips onto my BC, so if I want to use it, I just unclip it, you know, I can extend it, and then when I'm done, just clip it back on, and it doesn't get in my way. But anyways, use this to take the picture. It's the zoom, it's the power button, and then these little things on the back. These are the, arrow buttons and flash and camera, video, stuff like that. And you just open up the case. I always have an issue doing this because it's, there we go. Put that, put the camera in, shut her up, and you're good to go. That's the camera. Okay, now I've got to crawl over here. I cut myself. Ow, that hurt. This is what some people get really crazy over. I don't know why. But when I say everything's pink, I mean everything. And you will not have a problem finding me in the water. Because my tank is pink. Yes, this tank was maybe about $250. My tank, this little thing, I don't know if you see because it's on, there we go. This cap keeps the O2 ring, which is what the regulator hooks onto, keeps it safe, keeps dirt from getting into it. And then it's got, oh, there's a cap. It's got a boot on it right here, which keeps it from falling over and rolling around. And when it's full and you're about to go diving, you're not supposed to have it sitting up like this. You're supposed to have it laying down. Because if you have it sitting up, it can be knocked and pushed. And it can get damaged and dented. And you don't want dented. You don't want dented. You don't want dented tanks. It's made of aluminum. It doesn't have that much air in it. It's got like less than 500 PSI, which I would not be allowed to go diving with. And last but not least, probably the most important thing, and that is my BCU, or BC, buoyancy control unit, which is my vest, which again is pink. This right here, some people have an octopus that connects to their regulator. I don't. This is my octopus. This is in case your regulator fails. You have something to put in your mouth and fill up your BC with air to get yourself to the surface. I also have a dive knife on here, which a little rusty, but it's very, very sharp. And then I've also got a whistle. And it's got a little bag on it. It's got pockets where you put your weights. But this is a Zeagle Xena, which I think is pretty cool. It's not spelt like Xena, it's spelled with a Z. But, yep, that's my BCU. But now I'm going to try and put everything on and see how everything goes. So we'll see what happens.
Ariel, listen to me. The human world, it's a mess. Life under the sea is better than anything they got up there. The seaweed is always greener in somebody else's lake. You dream about going up there, but that is a big mistake. Just look at the world around you, right here on the ocean floor. Such wonderful things around you. What more are you looking for? Under the sea, under the sea. Darling, it's better down where it's wetter. Take it from me. Up on the shore, they work all day. Out in the sun, they slave away. While we're devoting full time to floating under the sea. Down here all the fish is happy, as off through the waves they roll. The fish on the land ain't happy, they saw cause they in the bowl. But fish in the bowl is lucky, they in for a worse fate. One day when the boss get hungry,
guess who got me on the plate?
But oh, under the sea, under the sea. Nobody beat us, fry us, and eat us in fricassee. We what the land folks loves to cook. Under the sea, we after hook up. We got no troubles, life is the bubbles. Under the sea,
under the sea,
under the sea.
Under the sea.
Since life is sweet here, we got to be here
naturally.
Even the sturgeon and the ray, did the earth start to play. We got the spirit, you got to hear it under the sea. The newt play the flute, the cop play the harp, the place play the bass and they sound the chop. The bass play the brass, the chub play the tub. The flute is the duke of soul.
Yeah.
The lake he can play the lings on the strings, the chub rocking on the blackfish. He sings the spelt and the sprat. They know where it's at, they know that blowfish blow.
Under the water,
yeah, we're in luck here, down in the muck here,
under the sea.